Welcome back to News Channel 34. We are live at the Oakdale Mall telling you about a benefit now to help out victims and the victims' families that were affected by the shootings at the American Civic Association on Friday. It's called A Community Comes Together, and that is exactly what we're doing here at the Oakdale Mall. We've partnered up with Catholic Charities, Clear Channel Media, and Citadel Broadcasting. Basically, we are collecting donations for the victims and the victims' families today until 8 o'clock p.m. tonight. The donation box will actually be here all week, so you can come on down at your convenience and put in anything that you can afford. We also have some cards here for the victims and the victims' families that were affected by the shootings on Friday. There are 14 cards. All 14 families are considered victims of the tragic shootings that happened Friday at the American Civic Association. Come on down and pay your condolences to those who are in need of your help now. Right now, we're going to toss things over to Joshua B. He's going to tell us about the response by the internet communities to what happened on Friday. Hey, Joshua.
That's right. It's actually really interesting. On Facebook, on Twitter, they've been talking about this tragedy since Friday morning. It's almost become sort of a digital way of leaving flowers at the site of a tragedy. People are even doing fundraising awareness through Facebook. One person even created a Facebook group for an original song they wrote about the tragedy. The song itself is very interesting, too. It has cut-ins from Vice President Biden's comments about the tragedy. But we're going to toss up the names of these different Facebook groups. You see, they have names like Binghamton, New York, United We Stand, Islamic Organization Fund to Help Families of Binghamton Tragedy, Binghamton Shooting Prayer Group, or this one, Why Did This Happen, the group's called, the Binghamton Shooting. Each group actually comes with a mini discussion board where people sort of publicly struggle to deal with this question. And Catholic Charities even has its own group to make people aware of the very fundraising event that Sophia was just talking about. Everyone has a different response to the tragedy, and so they sort of join the group that most falls in line with the way that they're feeling. And this isn't just happening on Facebook. This is happening on Twitter as well. Local individuals and organizations in Binghamton have really been sort of getting into Twitter. The B-Mets posted their response to the tragedy. It is with great sadness, they said, that the Binghamton Mets Baseball Club expresses its heartfelt condolences to those affected by the local tragedy. The United Way of Broome County used it in a very different way. They used it to actually assure people that none of their people were in the building when it happened. And then later they posted a link to the Catholic Charities website so people could actually donate. It's very interesting. If you go to search.twitter.com, you should check this out. In the same way that Google allows you to search the current news, Twitter search almost allows you to search people's current states of mind, what people are Twittering right now. Like for today, you probably see a lot of responses to the press conference that was held earlier today by the chief of police. So check it out, search.twitter.com. One local Twitter, twitter.com/Binghamton News, actually links to all of the local news stories that are currently going on, so you can keep abreast of things before you really hear them anywhere else. Make sure to check that one out. It's twitter.com/Binghamton News. Clearly, social networking has arrived as a way to mobilize support and charity. So you can actually take advantage of these to really know what's going on in the community. So if you stick around, we're going to take you to a little bit more of what's going on right here. There's people signing cards. You can come down here and join us right up until around 8 o'clock. We're going to be here. All 14 of these cards, like Sophia was just explaining, are going to the family of these victims. And I don't have to explain to you, obviously, how important it is that people come down here and acknowledge that. And actually, if you go online, if you go to Facebook, if you go to Twitter, you're going to see exactly how much people are talking about the event that's going on right here today. So make sure to stop down.